Hey everyone, it's Lexie. In today's video, I'm going to be doing a spoiler-free review of Garden Spells by Sarah Addison Allen. So, if you watched a lot of my videos recently, you know that I've done a lot of reviews on this author as of late. So, I've had two books that I've currently read of hers at that point in time, and I had three on my shelf that I haven't read of hers. So, I have reviews for those three that I just watched, that I just read, The Sugar Queen, Lost Lake, and then also Garden Spells. So I'll have everything linked down below so you can go check that out. But this was the debut novel from this author, and it was probably, I think it's my favorite of all the books that I've read of hers. So basically this follows a family that lives in this small town in North Carolina called the Waverlys, and they have something unique about them. Each woman in their family has a special gift, and they have this special garden that grows certain plants that you can use to, you know, you can reveal your deepest, darkest secrets, or an apple that you can see the future with. So it follows the three women, kind of, who are at different points in their lives. We follow Claire, who is really stuck in her ways. She just kind of does her thing. She's a caterer, and she just doesn't go out. She just does her job, like doesn't really kind of integrate, like put herself out there, I want to say, or integrate herself into society. And then that all changes when she kind of meets Tyler, who moves in next door, and that things take off from there. And then we also follow Sydney, who is Claire's youngest sister, and as soon as she could, she left her small town. She hated everything as being a Waverly, but we get introduced to her now, and she's currently running away from her abusive boyfriend, and she's coming back to her small town with her daughter. So she is kind of has a lot of issues. Their mother left them when they were really young. She just kind of abandoned them, and so she kind of followed in her mother's footsteps, but she is a better mother than her mother was, I guess you could say. So she's kind of fighting her own thing, and she doesn't really have, or to her knowledge, doesn't have that Waverly kind of special gift. Then we also get introduced to Evelyn, who is their cousin, who is a little bit older, but her gift is that she can, basically, she gives gifts for things that people don't know they need until they need it. So their kind of lives get thrown upside down when Sydney comes back, and just kind of rekindling their friendship and just small town, like little things going on. I will start out by saying I love this book. This is my favorite out of the authors. Like, it was so good and just really enchanting. I finished it within maybe 2 or 3 days. It was so good. The author has such a talent of making kind of the magical realism aspects into here, like that they don't like literally smack you in the face. They're woven into the story very seamlessly, and I really enjoyed kind of the little like magic in here as well. The characters, I really liked how we kind of got to see them grow as the story progresses, from when we first introduced them to where this book ends. It was really like neat to see that. I loved all the characters and just how their relationships changed and grow throughout the story. I love that. It was really, really neat. It has like, I could just picture being in this town and just all the other things going on. And I don't know, like how even like there's kind of like a little mystery aspect in here as well, which I very much enjoyed. There's some humor in here. It's just a perfect, nice, fun, happy read. I think this one, I don't know, like I think a lot of people really enjoy this, especially now in summer. It has to have that summery vibe that I think a lot of people are like. But I think, like, if you ask me, I think this is a good place to start in getting introduced to magical realism, because it's in there, but it's not like so abstract as like The Strange and Beautiful Sorrows of Ava Lavender. This one is a little bit more kind of, you know, hushed down, but it still does a really good job. I think there's a sequel to this as well, because it did leave on like a little cliffhanger. Like, there's a lot of loose ends that still need to be tied up, but I really enjoyed it. It's just a nice, fun summer read. I gave it like a 4.5 out of 5 stars. I really enjoyed this. So if you're looking for something fun, like a nice beach read, I think you would really enjoy this. It's really good. The characters are fun. Like, it's just a really good all-around nice summer happy beach read that you don't, it kind of distracts you from all like the terrible stuff going on in the world right now. So yeah, this one is a really good book, and I highly recommend it. So that's it, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comments below if you've read this book or if you're interested in reading it. So yeah, don't don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, and I will see you guys next time. Bye, guys!